how the neuron and the neural network and some basics algorithm. Okay, we seen today morning, and also now I'll be connecting some image processing with it and also the time series analysis. Okay, so both the things. Okay, even if you are having doubt, one more person also is there in the chat. I mean, in the meeting, person name is Netaji Nirmal. Even if you are chatting some doubts in previous, I was in the mood to explain those things. So if you are chatting some doubts, I think the Netaji Nirmal will be in the position to explain via the chat. I mean, clarify your doubts in parallel. Okay, if you are having doubts. Okay, I think he'll be helpful. And at the end of the session, he'll be sharing some more information also. Okay, now I'll be sharing my session. 1 minute. Yeah, I think the screen is visible to everyone. Yeah. So I'll be showing two different examples. Okay, in that how I'm just classifying it, and another example how I'm calculating it. Okay, I'm just explaining about a particular neuron. Okay, I'm just explaining about a particular neuron. So that's what I'm explaining to you. Okay, so here. So here I'm not running, because if I run, practically it will take 10 to 15 minutes time. So already executed result is there, so I'll be explaining via that result only. Okay, so here this is the project for connecting the blood clot happened in the human brain. Okay, partially it's completed, so I'm just explaining those things. Okay, even we were connecting to the breast cancers also. So due to India, I can't show those results, but I can give and clear view, but about how it is and what it is. Okay. So here I'll be connecting with the TensorFlow hub. Okay. If you are asking what is TensorFlow, means you know very well. It's an environment where you can able to work with the TensorFlow mechanism. So. And also one more thing is Keras. Okay, so the TensorFlow is initiated by the Google, and also after certain days the Keras is acquired by Google. Now the TensorFlow 2.0 is in the production and is in the market. Okay, the TensorFlow 2.0 is nothing but a combination of TensorFlow and the Keras. Okay, so here that's what I'm showing. Okay, so I'm just installing the TensorFlow hub package. Okay, so I'll be connecting the necessary package. What are the packages is required? Okay, here I'm having a classifier URL. Okay, so control click. Okay, so there is a n number of URL. I mean n number of algos there. So I'm just using the classifier URL which is available in the TensorFlow hub. Okay. This can be done in offline and also in online. So I'm just connecting via the online only. Okay. So even if you want some other architecture, means you can able to get. Okay, if it is a image, you can able to get. Okay, image classification. Lots of algos there. It is based on how you are going to take. Okay, it's purely based on the individual. What's the algo that they need to focus. Okay, so here I'll be using this one. Okay, so if I'm connecting this one, this has some predefined data set. Okay, this is a predefined model actually. So I'm connecting with that model. I'm just passing my data. Okay, so by passing my data, I'm just identifying under which category this falls. Then we changed the methodology. So I'll be explaining those methodology that what I changed also. Okay, what's the calculation that what I did. So I'll be explaining those things also. So at the initial stage, we initiated with this process, then we changed ourselves. So that's what I'm trying to explain it to you.
So please zoom.
Yeah, sure, sure. Okay, I think it's visible. So I'll be taking that image shape and what it is. Okay, so I connected to my, this is my friend website. So in that website, I connected this image. Okay, so I added this image into the server. Okay, so this is the real time images which is taken in 2018. Okay, so and for these images, if I'm taking the images, will be taking in a different angles. So the slice position is around 93 degree. Okay, so based on this degree, each and every degree the value is changing. Each and every degree the value is changing. Okay, so value means the image is changing. Based on that images only we are studying the result. Okay, by I mean if you are a doctor, let's assume if you are a doctor. Okay, so by seeing the image, the next moment you'll be saying, okay, he is having the blood clot at this point or something. Okay, based on his experience, he is saying, okay, so what's that experience, what's the calculation that he is having in his brain? So we are discussing with the doctors. How? Okay, so for if it is a 93 degree, if he sees something like a white color like this, okay, for 93 degree, if it is a white color, this is not a big problem. If it is a 92, if you are seeing the white color, it might be a problem. So based on the degree, his experience says, and based on the age also, his experience is, this is the problem, this is not a problem one. Okay, so we are getting those informations from the doctor. Okay, so at the initial stage, we just tried how to classify these things. So I'm just showcasing about the classification here. Then I'll be explaining in detail about how we are proceeding. Okay, so I'll be connecting this image and connecting with the each and every pixels. Okay, so connecting to the image labels what we are having. So I can show those image labels. So those classifier and image labels are connected. Okay, here n number of labels are there. Okay, so under which category this gets fall, under which category this gets fall. So we are just identifying. Even if I'm sharing a crow image, it should identify this is a bird. Okay, so we thought to connect at the initial stage, but after the prediction, it predicted this is nothing but a website, this is not a medical image, this is not something different. Okay, it predicted this is nothing but a website. Then only we started to identify, yeah, how the website is came. So in this image, this here you can able to see the close mark, and here minimize the restore. So these things we seen. So this is something like a browser. So the next moment it identifies this is nothing but a, this is classified under, this is nothing but a website. Okay, then only we identified we need to concentrate more on these images. Okay, in this space, we should not get the overall image, because if I'm connecting to the real-time images, connecting to the doctor and the scan center in Chennai, I mean the Annanagar, okay, they are not in the position to give the image directly. So they'll be having that particular tool. In that tool, they'll be taking the screenshot and they'll be providing those information. So like that only we are getting the real images. It's hard to get the real images actually. Okay, so like that only we receive the images. Okay, so for those cases we connected in a different way. So I'll be explaining those things. So here I'm just explaining with the classifier. Okay, so then I connected with some other methodology also, but after that we thought we have to change these methodologies. So if you are connecting with the classifier images, if you are connecting some images, what it is, so these things will be advisable. Okay, here you should have the already the model is ready. Yeah, over here via the TensorFlow hub. Okay, we need to use those model and we'll be getting those results. That's it. That's what we are doing over here. Okay, so here I'll be explaining here. I'm connecting the after that what I tried means I just open the image also and I'll be explaining. So I connected this image. Okay, so the slice position will be 77.4 degree. Okay, here you can able to see it. Here you can able to see it, 77.4 degree. So this is the brain image. Okay, so here only we can able to see something different. Okay, the blood clot. Okay, so we need, I mean already the image is in a grayscale. Okay, we need to identify this blood clot. Okay, we need to showcase, yeah, this is happening. Okay, based on this 77.4 degree, we are discussing with the doctor. Okay, if there is a white color at this place, whether it's a blood clot or not, at this some other place. Okay, for some other degree, for some degree, they will be saying, please ignore it. This is not a blood clot. Okay, for some degree, he is saying, yeah, this is a different one, this is another one. So this is something like a blood clot. So we are discussing with them and we are getting those information. So once we initiated it, okay, and now this one, yeah, here. So I am running that matplotlib, whatever it is, okay, and I am uploading the file. Okay, so 1.jpg, the same image that I uploaded it. So I'm just identifying the pin shape. Okay, 768x1024. Okay, so totally how many pixels? I mean, if you are connecting with the image processing, each and every pixel is a color. This color is having a number. Based on that number only, we will be saying the number is equal to the color. Okay, by connecting, grouping all the number together, all the color together, we are seeing that image. So that's what image processing works. So I mean, most of you knows these things. Okay, I'm just repeated again. Okay, so we started to see that. Then in this image, okay, the image is from around 350. I mean, in x-axis from 350 to 650 pixels, whereas similarly in y-axis around 280 to 600. Okay, but
sorry for the interruption, sir.
Yeah,
so if you could zoom the screen, it would be better for the participants to view, sir.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Thank you. So here this is a full image. I'm just cropping this image. Okay, so here it's the image starts from here for this degree. For some other degree, the image maybe starts from here. Okay, so we are identifying based on the degree. So here the image is around more than 370 in x-axis and less than 650. Okay, so in y-axis are around 300 or 270 to 600, I mean 560 or something. Okay, so this is the exact image we can able to visualize it. But whereas if I'm connecting each and every pixel, each and every pixel is having a number, a numeric number. Okay, we need to extract those number. Okay, we need to extract those number. Okay, but for my test case, I am focusing this point only. I am focusing this point only, this white color spot only. Okay, so because the rest of the spaces are being some the almost the value is same. So that's what I am focusing in x-axis 540 to 570. So here, this is 540 to 570 x-axis. Similarly, in y-axis 410 to 460. Sorry, 410 to 460. Yeah, Yeah. Okay. So I'm focusing this point only. I'm focusing this point only. Okay. So I'm just focusing this point. I'm just getting that corresponding numeric value. Okay. This is how we can able to get those numeric value. Here I just printed 1024 cars 768. This is the original image size. Okay. Whereas we took those data. So I just printed those data. Okay. So you can now I'm connecting with the PD. Pandas data frame. Okay. Once I'm connecting to the data frame, I can zoom out and I can able to show this to you. So here we are getting some numbers. Okay. So here 50, 53, some number are there. Whereas in this space, we are getting a different number. We are getting a different number. I'm just compare this. I'm just open with the paint. So I think this is visible to everyone. Okay. So so I'm just comparing this space only. So I'll reduce my brush size also. So I'm just comparing. This space, the red mark space only. Okay. If you are seeing that image, still you can able to visualize and we can you can able to see the shapes like this. So here are all 50s, here also 50s, 40s, but whereas in this space you can able to see 64, 68, 60, 59. If you are traveling via this path, you can able to visualize the what's the number is changed. So in core, if you are focusing in this 9500, 103, okay, this space. And here it's a 224. This is the maximum number. This is the maximum number. If I'm compare with this image, this point is around 224. This point is around 224. Okay. So we are getting those value. So if this value is exceeded, okay, this is a particular cell. Okay, so we need to calculate with the adjacent cells at the left side and left side, right side, top, bottom. Okay, so we need to calculate how much cell it's. I mean, it's beyond the threshold limit. Let's assume our threshold limit is 100. If it is greater than 100, there is some problem. Okay, there is some problem. Okay, if it is greater than 200, there is some bit serious problem. If it is greater than 300, this is again, it's based on the image scale what you are having. Okay, so we are calculating those info. Okay, if it is greater than 70 and less than 100, okay, this might be a minor one. Okay, we can able to identify the blood clot based on this image calculation. Okay, based on this image calculation, so we need to calculate. So then once you started to identify it, okay, you can, here I'm not done it. Okay, you can change, you can recreate an image by changing instead of 224, you need to identify the color of the red color. You just replace this number with a red color, then your image maybe looks like this. So practically you can say, yeah, you can spot the blood clot where it is. So the image will be something like this. Okay, the image will be something like this. So not only connecting with one image, this is only one neuron. This is only one neuron. Okay, so around we'll be calculating with 120 degrees. Okay, so it's again, it is based on the scan. Okay, for blood clot, they said about we can calculate with 120 degrees. Okay, so practically this is for 77.4 degree. So totally 120 degree. Each 120 degree will be having the decimals with 0.1, 0.1, 0.1. Okay, so into 10. So I'll be calculating with this. So practically 1,278 neurons will be there to decide whether they are having blood clot or not. Okay, so they need to feed the data. Okay, via that OCR recognition. Via that OCR recognition, we'll be identifying the slice position. Okay, so once we identify the slice position, this image will be fed to the corresponding neuron. Okay, and this image is not fed to the some other neuron. Okay, so if some other neuron is there, means it rejects. I mean, previously I shown, right, each and every neuron is connected. I mean, the neuron which is complete and the layer which is completed, okay, the data from the previous layer is connected to the particular neuron. Okay, so all the data from the previous layer is connected to the particular neuron. It's about the filtration process or rejection process. If the OCR is recognizing that 77.4 degree neuron is applicable, then it observes. Rest of the things are all it ignores. Okay, so it identifies the result and it processes. So practically, you should have, for one patient, you should have this much of images and this much of neurons. Let's assume instead of this much of images, if they are having only 50 images, the accuracy is different. If you are having images for all the decimals, I'm sure that the accuracy will be better. Okay, so again, it's based on the developer, how they were calculating, how they were working for those image processing. Okay, so like that only this project works. Okay, this blood clot works. This blood clot project works. So again, it depends upon the individual, how they were getting connected. That's what I'm trying. I mean, here I'm not using any ANN or CNN methodologies. I'm writing each and every neuron and what it is and how it is connecting with the OCR. Okay, so once we are connected with each and every neurons, okay, each and every neuron algorithm is designed by us, such with that this is a unique one. So collectively only we can say this is a project. Otherwise, this is a sample. That's it. Okay, that's what I'm showing it. Okay, so about, I mean, I'm just explaining an example. Okay, so I think you got some idea about what it is and how it is. Even I can give one more info also. Okay, I can give about what is CNN, okay, convolution neural network also. Okay, how the padding is done, how this process is done. If you are saying about the convolution neural network, let's assume I'm having a dog image like this. Okay, via the shredder I'm cutting in a vertical way. I'm just placing the odd in some other place and even in some other place. And collectively, all the odd images are there. Assume here I'm cutting image. So piece 1, piece 2, piece 3, piece 4, up to piece 100. Okay, 1, 3, 5, 7 are together. And I'm pasting it. And again, similarly for the even also. Okay, now I'm having two images. Now I will be cutting that both the images in a horizontal way. Okay, so I'll be having again 1, 3, 5 are connected together. So at the end, I'll be having four different images. Okay, all the four images are looks like the same. All the four images are looks like the same, but the original image is this one. Okay, via the CNN one, how we are using the subsampling. Okay, so like that only it works based on the images and it. Reduces the image size and it works based on that image compression. Okay, so like that only the convolution neural network works. Okay, so even if I'm connecting the convolution neural network, this is an one of the deep learning algorithm which can take an input image and even it can assign importance to various aspects or objects in the image and can be able to differentiate from one form to the another way. Even the pre-processing is required by other CoNet is much more low compared to the other classification algorithms. While in a primitive methodology, filters are hanged in engineered, while enough training convince our ability to learn these filter characteristics. The architecture of the CoNet is practically analogous. To the connectivity of the pattern of the neurons in the human brain, which is inspired by the organization of visual cortex. Okay, the individual neuron respond to stimulate only in the restricted region of the visual field known as a receptive field. That field we will be saying it is a receptive field, and even a collection of such fields overlaps to cover the entire visual area. This is how the CoNet works. Okay, here how we are sampling and how this processing is done, how the kernel means filtration, all these are done. I'll be explaining via the slide now. Okay, so here this is some intro about what is CNN. So I'm just going directly into that image. Okay. So let's assume this is the image that what you are having. This is the image that what you are having. Image means each and every image is having pixel. Each and every pixel is having a number. Okay, I'm connecting with some kernel. Kernel means the filtration matrix. Okay, so in this kernel is nothing but a filtration. Okay, in this kernel, the output is something like, let's assume this is M cross M and this is N cross M. Okay, so output will be M minus N plus 1 matrix. So 3 minus 3 plus 1. This is the output. Here you are having only one output. Okay, now I'll be explaining in detail about how these calculations are made. Okay, so I'm just placing over here. Okay, now it's a 3 cross minus 1, 2 cross 0 and 1 plus 1. Okay, so I'm connecting with the dot product. Okay, 3 into minus 1 and so similarly you can able to visualize it. So this is the output. Okay, by connecting the filter, so you can have a vertical filter, horizontal filter, diagonal filter, n number of filters are there. You can use the predefined filter or you can able to define a new filter such a way that if you are changing the number, if you are getting a advisable kernel which gives the exact output, I'm sure that's the best result. Okay, this 3 cross 3 images are converted into 1 cross 1 images. Okay, similarly, okay, so the filter, okay, the vertical line detector, horizontal line detector, corner detector, again, n number of filter. If you are searching via the internet, you can see the kernel is entirely different kernel. So in this, how much rows and columns in the input which is connecting to the filter, so that matters. Okay, so even I can show copy image and I can share that image also to you now. So this is in a JPEG. Sorry, I forgot to connect with the GIF. So if it is in a GIF image, then now I'll share that image and I'll show you now how this, in a video format, how these things are all connected. So for better visualization. Yeah, I sent desktop. This how this gets calculated. Okay, so this is the filtration. The yellow color is filtration, and green color is original image. Okay, after the filtration, connecting with the dot product, how the output is changing. So that's what I'm showing here. Okay, how the output is changing. So again, I'll be coming back to the slide again. I'll be going to explain that only. So here. Yeah. So the red color are all the images, okay, and blue color are all the filtration. I'm doing the sampling and connecting to the convolutions. Okay, so this is nothing but output. So here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 × 5, 5 − 3. This one is 3 × 3. 5 − 3 = 2 + 1 is nothing but a 3. The output is 3 + 3. So practically m minus n plus 1. So that's the formula for the output. Okay. So here the padding. Yeah. Okay. So here this how this gets calculated. So here for this I just shown the GIF image, right? For this space, I'm taking the kernel at this space. Okay. Again, I'm moving the kernel. Again, I'm moving the kernel. So by moving the kernel again and again to the entire phase, I'm calculating it. But whereas this is nothing but 5 − 3 + 1 is nothing but 3 × 3. This is the final output. Okay. So this is nothing but without padding. But we are not concentrating on this edge. Okay. If you are focusing on the padding, if you are focusing on the edges, edges means here. This space, okay. So we are considering on the top row, last row, and initial column and last column. Okay, we need to add the padding mechanism. So here I'm adding the padding mechanism. I'm doing this. Even the padding can be done with the zeros. Again, the padding can be done with the all or ones. It depends upon the project that what they are working. So here. I am considering these things also. So I am considering the edges also. Okay. So again, I am getting the output over here. Here, this is nothing but a 7 − 3 is nothing but a 4 + 1 is nothing but a 5. Now it's a 5 × 5. Okay. Even after the padding also, this convolution process is converted and it has some image capability. So that's what I am just showing. Again, kernel is. Up to you, and padding also up to you. Okay, if you are focusing on zero in general, they'll be focusing on, I mean, everyone is focusing on zero. Again, it's based on the project. You can easily change the value like anything. Okay, so this is not a normal matrix. This is our all images, and we are having a kernel. I mean, the filtration process. This can be done, and this can be fed into the output. So this how this the convolution mechanism works. And it reduces the image size. Okay, by reducing the image size, we can able to calculate the formulas also. So here also without padding, with padding, so all these examples. So I just explained it, what it is and how it is. Okay, so if I'm calculating this, okay, I think you knows very well about the dot product. Okay, you can calculate. So even you can create an own image, you can take an own image and you can work with those images also. So it's up to you, okay, to take these things. So here also what I'm trying to say is, okay, even if you are connecting with a deep learning mechanism, okay, how the kernel is working. Okay, if you are, I mean, for that the initial process, this so I can able to say, but whereas in a detailed manner means it's a different case. Different case means again it's purely based on the project how you are concentrating. Okay, so there only it plays a big role. Okay, so I think. I connected this CNN in a different way. Even I will be showing a for pages. Okay. Yeah. How it works. So the same thing that I'm focusing with. Yeah, I think you got some idea about how it works. Okay, so how you are reducing those image sets. So it's again it's individual areas. So now I'll be connecting with time series analysis. Okay, before explaining about the time series analysis, I just give base idea of how the time series analysis is working. Okay, generally if I'm connecting, I'll be using this the same example what I used in yesterday, connecting with Panimala. I'll be using the same example. So because why I'm using this means this is easily you can able to understand what it is and how it is. Okay. So now I'll be connecting with the pin. So let's assume there is a three different lane. This is lane one, lane two, lane three. These things are all road. Okay, here we are having a car, something like this. So I'm just connecting red color, not red, little bit yellow color. So this is a one car, and I'll be connecting with pink color. This will be another car, and I'll be connecting one more color. Okay. So here I'm giving the condition that this blue color car has to overtake the pink color car. That's it. This is the logic that I'm giving. Okay, even let's assume you are the one who is driving this one. Okay, before road, I'm connecting with the autonomous car. Okay, so let's assume you are the person, you are the machine, so you are going to drive, and how your logic works, the same thing has to be incorporated into the autonomous car also. Okay, so let's assume by basic you have to overtake via the right side only. You are just verifying with the right side there is another car, so you'll be switching on the horn and you'll be taking at the left direction, you are overtaking this car. So practically what happens means, yeah, I'll be connecting with red color. So this car has to reach this place. This blue color car has to reach this place. Okay, whereas if it goes, theoretically, if it goes straight, the car will reach this place. But this is the deviation that you took. So this is something like a triangle. This is something like a triangle. Okay, practically what you need to concentrate means you need to concentrate on how much degree you need to bend the angle. Okay, so let's assume this angle might be 15 degree, 15 or 20 degree. Okay, the angle of deflection should be 20 degree. Practically, you won't take left and go like a diagonal, and you can will be falling like this. So practically, you are not doing like that. Okay, even if I'm continuously drawing this diagram, this is something like this, and again, if I'm drawing this straight line. Okay, So at this stage, we started with a 20 degree deflection. Here you should go, you should not continue with that. You have to bend at the right. I mean, here you took left side 20 degree. Here you need to go straight, so that you need to take right side 20 degree. Then only you can able to achieve the condition. Okay. So practically, this is not possible. This is by theoretical, this is the possible. But practically, if you are riding the vehicle, you'll be riding the pattern somewhat like this. Like this means. Like this. This is the reality. Okay. So again, you need to concentrate on how much degree you need to bend. Yeah. Okay. So practically this shows around 45 degree. Let's assume 45 degree. Okay. If you are taking 45 degree to the left, at the end, you should have taken 45 degree to the right. But practically you can't take 45 degree to the right at this space. Okay. So by connecting here, you took 45 degree here. Again, you are taking 1 degree to the right. Here around 2 degree. Here you are taking around 6 degree to the right. Here again you are taking 1 degree to the right. Okay. Here you are taking around 2 degree, 3 degree. Based on the place, based on the situation, okay, at each and every instance, okay, you took 45 degree to the left while riding. Okay, you are calculating this distance is nothing but 100 meters. Let's assume the distance between blue car and pink car is 100 meters. Okay, so you took before 100 meters, you took 45 degree to the left. After 100 meter, you took 45 degree to the right, but gradually you took. Okay, so this happens within 30 seconds. Okay, so for each and every milliseconds, how many degree you are taking while you are rotating your steering? Okay, how much degree you are taking back? So this you are having in your brain. This calculation you are having in your brain. So this is the same calculation you have to incorporate into the machine. I mean the autonomous car. Okay. So time series. Each and every milliseconds you are changing the angle. Okay. So I said it's 1 degree, 1 degree. So if I'm continuously connecting, so practically you'll be saying each and every millisecond there is a change in degree. So 30 seconds practically. Okay. 1 millisecond is 1000. Okay. So 1000 cross around at least 30,000 data happened within that 30 seconds. You overtook the car, but 30,000 data by practical, you'll be having some 3 to 4 lakhs of data within 30 seconds. You need to calculate with those 3 to 4 lakhs of data. So that much of GPU you should have in your car. So that much of capability, that much of spot response you should have in your car, then only your autonomous car will work. So this is also a time series analysis. I'm just explaining with how the why the time series analysis is so important. Okay. And how you need to calculate about this time series. 1 minute, please. Sundar, your Karthik is present. Yeah. So how much these things you need to focus. So that's what I'm trying to explain. So this is best example for what is time series analysis. Now I will be going in depth about the time series analysis now. And I will be explaining with the real-time data also. Okay. Now itself. Okay. So whenever I'm connecting with the deep learning, I will be always taking with the time series analysis, because it's not only the image processing, it's the deep learning. Okay. So By connecting the time series analysis, if you are connecting the deep learning, your AI will work. Even I'll be explaining with how this works clearly. So everything I'll be explaining. Even with the share market also, I can able to explain how it works. Okay. So, yeah. So if you are in the position to connect with the time series analysis, okay, most of the project will work based on the time series analysis only. Okay. So for real-time data, okay. So if I'm saying about the time series analysis, just now I clearly explained to you about what is time series analysis. Okay, if I'm saying about the time series analysis, it has some sequence of data. It can be looks like, continuous or discrete. Okay, so it based on the individual, how you are connecting with the continuous form or discrete form. So both are works fine. Okay, so even the data is regular or irregular, everything we need to connect with the time series analysis. Okay, so here, okay, so practically it will be applicable in economic, stock market, even you might have seen in the last cricket World Cup. Okay, Intel is introduced some sensors in the bat. Based on the pattern, how he works, based on, again, it connects with the time series analysis. Okay, so everything we can able to detect, and this time series analysis will be helpful for forecasting. Everything is only for the predictive analysis. Okay, forecasting before happening what it might be. So this analysis can be helpful for time series analysis. Okay, now today this has happened, what might be the tomorrow? Okay, so this is a generic one. Okay, so that's what I'm not explaining about what is anomaly detection, all these stuffs. So I'm just skipping those things. I'm just explaining about the time series components. Okay, so if I'm saying about the time series components, practically we'll be having the three different components. One is a trend, another one is a seasonality, and another one is a residue. And if I'm saying about the trend, it's a long-term direction. Even for, if I'm asking you around 1 year back, what might be the trend? Okay, practically we'll be saying, if you are in Tamil Nadu, you know, this the trend might be the Nesamani. Okay. So even if I ask in February or March month, what might be the trend? Okay, from February to till today, the COVID-19 is the trend. Okay, so even with the different hashtag, we'll be connecting with what might be the trend. Now what might be the trend means practically most of the people connecting to the IPL in future, in few days, the Big Boss 4. So I'm not commenting those things. I'm just explaining, okay, what it is. Okay, even around 1 week back also in Tamil Nadu, we might have seen Tamil Theriyadu, Hindi Theriyadu Poda. So these things are all became a trend. Okay, this is for a long-term direction. Okay, so how the trend looks like? The trend looks like this. Okay. So this is the actual curve, the black is actual curve. The yellow color is identifying the trend, whether it's upfall or downfall. Okay, mostly it can be upfall or downfall. Even if it is a steady, there also it says the trend is steady now. The trend is steady now. Okay, it will be identifying the trend. Even today's share market also is coming down, it's in the downfall. Even I will be seeing those examples also now with live data. Okay. And the seasonality is a periodic one. Periodic one means, okay, by basic we know very well about the rainfall season is around from September end to November end. Okay, so again, the festival season, it kickstarts from Vinayaka Chaturthi to till the Pongal. Okay. And so in those festival mood, we can able to see the nuts price will increase little bit, and also the dress. Okay, we can able to see different offers in the dresses. Okay, so like the Aditya Birla fashion, they are the one who is owning the Pantaloons. Okay, the share market price for those Aditya Birla Fashion will increase. Whereas in February, March month, the Aditya Birla price will get reduced. So these things are all seasonal one. Okay, this is a periodic one. So not only these things, I mean, even if you are connecting, I mean, as in once you woke today morning, generally you go and take a cup of tea or coffee or some other drink, then so these are the procedures that you are using. So this also is a seasonality one, okay, on daily basis, with the period of daily basis. It's again, the period can be a minute, hour, day, week, month, year, a decade, even 2020 COVID came in, 1920 something is came. You might have seen, I forgot those name also. So this also is something like a seasonality. Okay, if you are staying in 2120, there also we may get fear, because for past 300 and 1920, 1820 also something is came. Okay, so these things are all something like a seasonality. I'm just saying an example. Okay, so this is the periodic one. Okay, and the third thing is ritual. This is a purely a random one. Okay, so it's hard to connect with the trend and the seasonal pattern. It is a random one. That's it. It can be anything. Yeah. Okay. So by basic three components are there. How in these three components, how you are decomposing those components? Okay. So we'll be using three different methodologies. One is additive. One is a multiplicative, and that is the pseudo addictive decomposition. Okay, if I'm connecting with the addictive decomposition, okay, so I'm connecting with the observation. Observation, the result might be a combination of trend, seasonality, and real addictive. Okay, it's not that it's always trend plus seasonality plus residual. It depends upon the projects. By basic, I'm saying it shows the trend plus seasonality plus residual. Assume if you are not having a residual, this is something like a trend plus seasonality. Okay, so it can be anything. Okay, so this is the addictive time series analysis. Okay, and this is something like a trend plus seasonality. Okay, again it's a periodic signal and connecting with the trend. Okay, this is something like a trend plus seasonality, and a multiplicative model also, trend cross seasonality class residual. Even we can convert this multiplicative model into the addictive model by taking the log on both the side. Okay, log of time seasonality residual is log of time plus log of seasonality plus log of residual. So observation, log of observation is nothing but a addictive model. Okay, so this may be the multiplicative time series model. Okay, so this is something like addictive model, this is something like a multiplicative model. Okay, so the pseudo addictive is nothing but a combination of both addictive and multiplicative. Okay, it can be like anything. Here it's written some formula: trend of time t of seasonality of minus one. So here these two are multiplicative, and here this thing are all addictive. Again here addictive, again it's multiplicative. It's not the thing, the formula, this should be the formula. It can be anything. It can be anything. The one and only thing is based on the project, what's the formula that you are rewriting it. Okay, formula means the algo. Okay, it's based on the project about what you are working. Okay, so this how the decomposition of the time series can work. I mean, can be calculated. Okay, I mean, these things are all the basic fundamentals of how these things are all working. Okay, so now I'll be explaining about the stationary and non-stationary data. Okay. Stationary data means it has some constant mean and constant variation. Okay, based on this we'll be connecting how this can be done. It's not connecting to trend, it's not connecting to the heteroscedasticity. Okay, how you are calculating it. So here if I'm calculating the mean, okay, so this is the data set, the mean is almost zero. Okay, so here by basic, if you are calculating the variance, So the variance will be this much to this much. This is the variance here. Even if you are connecting with the autocorrelation is nothing but the same data with in a different time zone. Cross correlation is a different case. We are connecting with the different datas. The same data with the different time zones. That's nothing but a autocorrelation. Even while I'm connecting with the correlation, okay, how this will be? Okay, now it's increased, it's decreased, but by connecting the additive methodologies, so how the autocorrelation output might be looks like? This how it looks like. Okay, so why this stationarity? So while connecting the demo, you can able to identify it. So one is a stationary, another is a non-stationary. Okay, here we can't identify the mean. Here we can't identify the variance. It's changing. Okay, and heteroscedasticity. Here also, if I'm connecting this one only, we can able to say this is something like a stationary data. If I'm connecting this part, this is something like a stationary data. Okay, but all together, this is not a stationary data. This is a non-stationary data. Okay, so that's what inside the non-stationary data, the heteroscedasticity in the different way. So that's what it shows heteroscedasticity. If everything is same, the stationary data, the another name of stationary data is homoscedasticity. Okay, so in the non-stationary data, it's really heteroscedasticity. Okay. So here how the trend might be. Okay, so again identifying now, here I'm seeing the run sequence plot. Now I'll be connecting with some real example, like let's assume I'm taking this one. So I'm removing all these things. So this is the data of Bank Nifty. Bank Nifty means around 12 to 13 banks collectively together. This only which defines the Indian bank positions. And if I'm connecting with the Nifty, that only defines the Indian market position. So here everything is red due to the second fall in the COVID. Okay, so for past few days. Okay, so this is the real data. Okay, real time data. So I'm connecting with those real time data. Okay, so now I'm this is the running plot. If I'm seeing it, this is a candlestick. Okay, if I'm connecting, so this is something like a continuous one. This is something like a discrete one. It depends upon the individual how they are focusing. So this is the runtime plot. Practically, this is the runtime plot. Okay, even I'm connecting with a day-wise chart. Even if I'm connecting with the 1 minute chart, you can able to see the change in the value. Yeah, it's changing. It's changing. Okay, so each and every second it's changing. So for each and every minute, what might be the value? So everything you can able to visualize it. Okay, so in this, how we are identifying, how we are taking the decision. So that decision can be done by the smoothening of this curve. Okay, so again I'll be coming back here. There also I shown today morning, also I shown with the dot summary, the statistical summary, the coefficient we are all identifying. So these things are all we can able to with via connecting the stats model, we can able to get those summaries. Histogram plot, augmented key plot, is so n number of non-stationary time data we can able to identify. So that's what it's explained in this here. Also here I'm showcasing the mean for stationary. The mean is almost same. Okay, the variance is also almost same. Here the mean is entirely different. So this we are defining, this is nothing but a non-stationary data. Okay, so if everything is almost approximately same, then only we are saying. Okay, so again non-stationary data in the variance. Okay, in the mean also I we might have seen Okay, in variance also we can able to see. So similarly, the histogram. So these things works. So now I'll be connecting with the smoothening. Smoothening, in the smoothening only we will be calculating with how it can be. We are doing the predictive analysis mechanism. Okay, smoothening means by basic simple average smoothening, equal weightage, exponential. Everything is something like a moving average. Okay, so average means I'm just calculating it and divide. I mean, if it is a 10 samples. Adding all the samples and dividing by 10. This is nothing but average. But whereas moving average is a different case. Okay, the smoothening curves which leads to give the better result and which can takes I mean most of the AI which is connecting to the smoothening curve. Not only smoothening. These are all the one of the neurons. That's it. Okay. So here I'm connecting the mean square error. Okay. If it is a mean square error, let's assume this is the data. This is the data, okay. This is the measurement, what it is. So this is the expected one. So 1.5 minus 1.3 the whole square plus 2 minus 2.2 the whole square. Okay, like this, if I'm making the squared error is nothing but this is the final result. So mean square error means divided by 6. This is the mean square error. There also you might have seen SST, SSR, SSA. Today morning we might have seen, okay. Why are that SST equal to SSR plus SSE? Okay, SSE is nothing but YI minus Y hat of I the whole square. I mean summation of everything. Okay, so that's also a mean square error. Okay, this error should be less. If it is less, I'm sure that this is a exact result. Okay, the, practically we can't see anything without error, but we need to identify how much error it is. Okay, how much error it is, and we need to have the model which shows the least error. So that's what we might have seen OLS methodology, ordinary least square. Okay, so in this model, I'm connecting with the moving average. Okay, so let's assume this is the data. So I'm taking the padding of a window size of 3. Okay, 1.5 plus 2 plus 2.5 divided by 3 is nothing but a 2. Yeah, again I'm taking next 3, 2 plus 2.5 plus 3 is nothing but a 2.5. Okay, so again if I'm takes like this, this entire data will be connecting to this. Okay, you can ask, yeah, already the data is there, why you are doing this? Okay, by smoothening this curve, you can able to predict, okay, what might be the next one. You can able to forecast it. Okay, whether it's in the uptrend or downtrend, you can able to forecast it. So I'll be showing those demo also. Okay, so yeah, here I'm connecting in a day-wise pattern. Okay, so I'm going to add the indicators. In indicators, expo moving average exponential. Okay, I'll be adding 3 times. So if it is 9, this is nothing but a 9 days moving average. All are on 9 days moving average. I'm going into the settings and I'm changing the color and making input as a 9. Let it be 10. Okay. So again, I'm going with another thing. 5. This is 5 day moving average. Again, I'm this also I'm going to edit it. Three day moving average. Okay. So what we can observe from this? Generally, this is exponential moving average. Okay. Why are this exponential moving? What's the decision that I can able to take? Okay, such a way that I can able to forecast it before it happens. Okay, so here all the moving averages are intersected at a particular point. Now everything opens up with the proper with the different degrees. Okay, so everything opens up with the different degrees. So the orange color is 5 day. Dark blue is 10 day and light blue is 15 day. Okay, so Here, if here you can able to see at this point, okay, on 25th August, it shows there is a huge open up. There is a huge open up. Okay, practically this is the right time for you to invest. So after intersecting, if it is opens up, here we can able to take the decision. Okay, it will be in the uptrend for few more days. Or I mean, again, when the 5-day moving average gets reduced. Okay, so till here it's in the uptrend. It can able to identify it. So if you are investing or something, okay, so you can able to plan the investment at this space. And actually I'm not explaining about the share market, so I'm explaining about the time series analysis, how you can able to take the decision by based on the smoothening the curve. You are predicting the right time to invest and right time to come out, even if I'm connecting with around 6 months of data. Here also you can see, so it's intersected, it's in the uptrend. So if I'm invested on 24th August, okay, I'll be seeing a good profit till 28th August for 4 days. Okay, this will be in the uptrend. So by connecting, so here only we the humans are taking the decision, the statistical analysis decision. Okay, this can be done. So if the same thing incorporated into the program like AI, the AI says, okay, this is the right time to invest, get it and get the result, connect it and get the result. Okay, so these things can be done, okay, by connecting this info. Okay, so not only this, so here I'm connecting with the exponential moving average. Even if you are focusing I can show the result of what happened in COVID also. So here you can able to see everything is intersected, it's in a downtrend. Okay, so you need to sell it and buy. Sell call you can able to work. Okay, so the these are the place which is not advisable to invest. Okay, if it is intersecting, don't invest. If it is showing uptrend or downtrend, it's advisable to invest. Okay, so this is from the share market. Even if I'm connecting with something else also, I can able to, I mean, something else means some other stocks also, I can able to show it. Even for the gold also, you can able to see. Yeah, so this is the place where the US and Iran fight happened. There itself we started to see the gold price is very high, but whereas it's a different trend. Now the trend is entirely different. The gold prices is reducing a lot. Okay, again it depends upon the data that what we are focusing. And even if I'm connecting the entire data here, you can able to see there is a huge price in the gold. Okay, again it's reduced like anything. Okay, the thing is here the recession is happening, the world is in unstable, the gold will increase. If the world is stable, the gold will decrease. So this is the generic sentimental analysis. Again, I'm not explaining those things. So again, how you are connecting with the time series analysis, so that's what I'm explaining now. So even I can able to remove the 15 days and I can able to add some other indicator like Bollinger Bands. So where you can able to take the decision, Bollinger Band which connects to the 20 days moving average also. So now I'll be connecting with 1 month data. 1 month data means one day data. Connecting to the Bank Nifty. If I can connect with the Bank Nifty. So if there is a downfall, okay, if there is a big variation, sudden change, the variance will show, okay, this is the midpoint, this is a 20 days moving average, the variance will show, okay, this is the right time for you to invest. Okay, if the variance is compressed together, okay, the upper band and lower band are connected together, then this is not the right place for you to invest. Where it changes, where it bulges. So that's the point where you can able to invest. So these things will be having in your brain by experience. So the same thing, each and everything is it's a neuron. You need to calculate with the neuron, then only you can able to say this is nothing but algo based trading. Okay, so I can able to connect with image processing also. I can able to connect with the trading also. Even we can able to connect with the autonomous vehicle also. Okay, so how you are connecting, how the neuron works. So that's a challenge. That's the experience that you are having, and that's a capability. There only you can able to visualize the data such a way that which will be helpful for you to connect. Even I can show some examples, like not sure, but okay, let it be the stock predictive analysis. So I'm taking the necessary packages. Okay, I'm taking the Ashok Leyland datasets from 2012 to 26 August 2020. Okay, so I'll be having 2129 of rows and 6 columns of data. Okay, high value, low value, open close, volume, adjacent close. Okay, so I'm plotting that particular graph. Okay, I'm taking only the close data. Okay, so here so this will be the open data. If it is a red color, the down will be the closed data. If it is a green color, this will be the open data and up will be the closed data. So I'm taking the closed data for each and every day. Okay, here I'm showing with the 1 minute candle. So here you can connect with the data. I'm just drawing the graph. Okay, I'm taking the filtration process. The duplication data are all removed. Okay, so I'm connecting with the min max scalar. Okay, it is the what might be the minimum value, what might be the maximum value. Here this is the minimum value, this is the maximum value. This is considered to be 0, this is considered to be 1. It falls under the 0 to 1 scale. So that's what I'm doing with the min-max scalar. Okay, so I'm training with the AX data. I'll be training with the last 60 days dates of data. Okay, so I'm adding all those data. Okay, I'm just fitting the data by input sizes 1. Okay, so then I'll be connecting with the predictive analysis. Even I can able to run it, that doesn't matter. I think it will take maximum of 2 to 3 minutes. Okay, run means I can able to I'm connecting the data till today until 20th of September. So here so this is a different, now it's changed. So I'm not explaining everything in detail. So I'm just explaining how it works. So how we are forecasting. Okay, here we'll be using LSTM algorithm. Okay, practically LSTM means long short term memory networks. Okay, so this algorithm is an artificial recurrent neural network architecture. Okay, which will be useful for DL, which can be useful for connecting the handwriting recognition, speech recognition, anomaly detection, and again this also. Okay, so everything is connected. Okay, now I'm connecting with the mean square error. So I'm just fitting with the data. So we need to wait till the entire data gets trained. And I will be forecasting about what might be the data for the next day. Okay. Practically, we are connecting only with the mean square error. Okay. So we are taking only with one neuron. The accuracy will be very, very less. If you are connecting with more parameters, we can feel the better accuracy. Okay. Yeah. It's trained. RSMA root mean square error. Okay, so I'm just validating everything, and again I'm plotting the graph over here itself. So the orange color graph are all original one. The green color graph are the predictive graph. Yeah, based on the mean square error, we are calculating it. Okay, so that's what we are doing. Now we'll be connecting with 24. Till we had connected the data set till 20th, right? So here we can able to connect with till 20th. We'll be predicting what might be the result for the next day. Okay, so sorry, it should be 9. So far we connected with the trained data. Now we are connecting with the test data. I'm testing with the data. So it's a 76 almost. Okay, so I'm connecting with Ashok Leland, and I'm connecting with the Davis chart. Okay, day wise chart means September. Sorry, September 21st. September 21st closing price will be 74.5, but ours is calculated with 76. This is not an exact result. This gives an error, but we connected with only one neuron. By connecting with the multiple neurons collectively together, we can able to define, okay, what might be the rate for tomorrow. Okay, we can, here it's not connected with the sentimental analysis, RSI parameters. So we are not connected with the multiple statistic model. We are just connected and we are using. So this is how we can able to forecast the data of the time series analysis. Here also the DL and AI is using. If we are predicting the tomorrow's result, and if it is accuracy, the AI based algorithm, this is artificially it identifies the tomorrow's rate. So now I can able to plan for whether I can invest or not. So everything is connecting to that. This also comes under the time series analysis. So I think you are getting some ideas about how for the platform, you can use Google colab.research.google.com. Even I can connect with Intel based. So whenever I'm connecting with the training, I always say, okay, if you want to learn ML, please go ahead and I'm just copying this link. Go ahead and connect with this Intel link. So machine learning, deep learning, AI, okay, everything, okay, time series analysis, NLP, anomaly detection. So even FPGA, deep learning with Intel FPGA, everything is available. Everything is for free. First, you can able to initiate it and you can able to learn. So they are not providing any video tutorials. They are giving the data set. The one and only thing you have to sit and learn, okay, in detail. So this is how you can able to connect. Instead of connecting with some other course, you are learning that ML and DL under the standard platform. Okay. So even I'll be sharing those links also. So I think Netaji is giving answers to the people. Yeah, yes, Netaji, are you in the line?
Yes, sir. Yes, I'm in. I'm just opening the chat boxes.
Yeah. So you can give some information about deep learning also, please.
Yes, sir. First of all, good morning, everyone. It's glad to see you all. I'm Nirmal. and I could see many professors here, I think. So I could address them with my short term of experiences. Okay. So I think you would have, I was not present in the first session, actually. I joined you in the second session. What could I tell you was, I could tell you a short story where I could explain what could be done for the betterment of India as well as the students. Okay. If you're a student, it's not a problem. Just you can get this point. Okay. Let me start the story. Initially, in 1990s, 1980s and all, I'll just take a car as an example. For manufacturing a car, generally an architect and a mechanical engineer would be more than enough to build a car. Okay. Meanwhile, after 1990s and all, electrical ignition systems, different sensors, parking sensors and all came in. At those point of time, an electrical engineer, an electronic engineer, and a mechanical and an automobile engineer and an architect were required to manufacture a single car. Okay. But in the current time, present time, what happened is, you guys would know, there's a concept of autonomous cars, which is in the market. For example, Tesla, Elon Musk is the owner of it. So in the current time, what it requires to make just a single piece of or a single unit of car is a mechanical engineer, an automobile engineer, electrical, electronic engineer, as well as an IT CSE professional. Okay. And this is the current time scenario. And in the very near future, you would be getting displays, television displays, marketing displays, everything in your, car screen itself. And then the whole health, that is including your mental health, your physical health, everything will be measured as soon as you get into your car. Okay, this will be the status of cars in the near future. So ultimately, what I'm trying to say is, in the near future, to just manufacture a single unit of car, all the engineers belonging to different all the engineers belonging to different departments, as well as doctors, psychologists, everyone would be required to manufacture a single car. Okay. So in the similar way, we should start thinking now itself. Okay. For now, Indian government as well as the Asian countries are trying a lot to improve in technology, since the US countries are well versed in technologies. So they're trying to bring up as much as possible in the technological field. So we should start thinking ahead of the future, and we should plan and develop students according to it. Okay. So this is what I was trying to explain. So even, as boss was teaching about that, today there's a headline about Tesla. We were speaking about autonomous cars, right? So today there was a very big news about Tesla. The thing is, internal servers and server rooms of the Teslas were affected. So that what happened is, many drivers and many owners of Tesla cars were not able to open their cars, because in most of the Tesla cars and online, an internet connected keys or biometric keys would be used for accessing their car doors, actually. Okay. So what happened is, there was a server problem. And in the meanwhile, the drivers were not able to access their cars. And a big news happened. Okay, let me share a screen where I could connect it with also the share market. Okay. Where it is? Yes. So here, you could see that the share market price, that is each share of Tesla, has dropped 10% in today's session. Okay. So what happened is just a single news. That is which news? The internal servers are not working. That's it. The complete share of Tesla had gone down 10% within one single day. So what I'm telling to, I'm trying to explain here is, so we have to stay connected with technology, as well as the education system, as well as the government, as well as the student mind, and all the aspects. And we should make them prepared for everything, because you guys will know that after the corona pandemic, the whole world, the whole education system got changed. And I don't want to name those companies, big companies who are teaching online came into the play. Okay, so it's not sure that in the near future the teaching system would not be as same as it is today. Okay, so we should keep all those factors which belongs to economical factors, social factors, physical factors, and all the factors by which teachers are going to get affected. Okay, so we should have all these things in our minds, and we should work according to it, and we should think according to it. So that's all. You could post your questions up, and if you have any doubts, I'll be answering it in the chat session. If you have any other doubts, you can ask Shabari as well as me. Thank you, guys.
Yeah, thank you Netaji. Okay,
yes, yes sir.
I'd like to thank if you're having doubt, you can ask. Even I will be connecting with Professor Arun. Okay, he's a great person for me, connecting with me for more than 4-5 years. Okay, so I'm happy to see with him, obviously, for providing the knowledge sharing space. And thanks for the management, and again especially thanks for the participants who are having the enough patience, okay, to view it. And even if you are having any feedback, you can share the feedback, or even if you are having doubts, you can share. Even I would like to thank everyone. Yeah, Arun sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for your valuable presence. Am I audible, sir?
Yes.
Yeah, sir. Thank you, Shabrinath, sir, for spending your valuable time with us. And dear participants, I request you to use a resource person very effectively, even after this session also. He has got a very good knowledge in terms of Intel tools. Please do utilize him. I will be sharing his mail ID with all the participants post the session in the WhatsApp group. Please do utilize him. And sir, thank you once again for spending your valuable time with us. Always, whenever we need you are always here to help us to provide the sessions. Thank you on behalf of Panimular Institute of Technology, sir. As a token of appreciation, I'm just sharing my screen with a small memento virtually. Please do accept it.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Nathan, sir, for joining this session. It was so informative that you also shared your views about how teaching should also be in the near future. Thank you, sir.
Yes, thank you. Thank you so much, sir.
Provide convolution PPT, sorry, GIF, another GIF.
Yeah, I'll share everything to.
Yeah, the GIFs were very nice. They were giving the concept directly.
Oh, okay. Sure. I'll share it now. Okay, I'll share it now.
Very nice session.
Okay, thank you, madam.
And dear participants, if you have any other feedbacks also, you can unmute yourself and then you can give it for your own. And the feedback link is also posted in the chat box. Please do fill the feedback form too.